Hello and welcome back to my channel. This is Melody Lynn, and we are going to play. What game to play next and decided on this one. Let's be a Canis dog. Play. There we go. So, yes, I decided on Xing because I really like puzzle games and that's what this is. So, and it's a beautiful one. At that, we are going to be traveling to different lands and hearing the stories of people in the past and helping them to resolve their lives, I guess. Learning from their lives too. It's a big door with a thing, a mechanism. This is a beautiful game, seeing that we hit shift to run. We don't want to run right off the edge. We're up in the clouds. Spaces to jump. And Z zooms. Look at that. A sign that we can't read. Oh, it's a waterfall. Another sign that we can't read. I'm hoping eventually we'll be able to read those. Zenith. And there's our dog symbol. Looks like we toss it in there. Guardian and the only true living thing in this place. You exist now on a higher plane, a zenith of worlds. But worry not, in death you have much still to do, and I shall be there to help guide you through the scattered pools rooted in the ground. So we're dead. Okay. Now go forth on flowing tides towards its Iztali point, an idyllic oasis among treacherous oceans, and discover what it means to be alone again. So we have doors to choose from, but it looks like we want to go over there. Sign over here. I wonder if we can't To enter the forest, heed this tune. You must collect one shining mirror. Okay, so we can't go in there. Well then. Oops. Come on. Come on. Hurry up there. Okay, follow me to a hole. There we go. Look. Oh, I'm so good at getting stuck. Okay. Let's jump from stepping stone to stepping stone. To get to a sign that we can't read.
We were a small nomadic tribe. On these islands, we learned to thrive. We lived in harmony with the land, a people of the sea and sand. Scouting atop the waves one day, a looming storm swept us astray. We screamed and gasped to stay alive, but in the end, only I survived.
Lua. Part of the wreckage. That's what I thought that might do. Let's see what this is down here. We can pick up a coconut. Nothing. Apparently, we want a puzzle piece. Open, open, open. Okay. Then I guess we go this way. Oh, you want coconuts. Me too. A little treasure chest up here that we can open. That must say, here's a treasure chest. Let's open it up. A puzzle piece.
For days I tried to leave this place, on planks of wood I tightly laced. But every time, as if on cue, a terrifying storm would brew, and darkened skies began to crack as the restless tides drew me back.
This is a fucking good spot to leave from. is here. Some do their best thinking at night. Well, I do because I walk at night. Sun and moon. And a coconut. And a button.
I should see a sickness crept up over me, a pain which I'd never known, the thought that I would die alone.
I think it would be nice to be stranded alone on the desert island, but I guess after a while you would get pretty lonely. We're social people. Okay, so that just flips that back and forth. And that wants a pineapple. And there's a thing over there. There is no courage without fear. Those who explore are often rewarded. Well, then, let's explore. Hello there. There's a door. Golden fruit grows nearby. Pineapple. Don't know where it came from, but we found a pineapple.
Hanging alone in the sky, a fate shared by the moon and I, a circle round and glowing bright amidst the stars, my guiding light. Thank you.
on the archway.
Was in the air and beckoned me. Do not despair. With hope restored, I carried on, fighting to live for another dawn.
So we can change it from day to night.
Resolved to make my way, to travel forth both night and day, using these giant walls of stone to scratch a living on my own.
Well, at least it's not like a desert island. It's pretty, actually. Okay, let's make it now.
My people traveled near. The fires I built would guide them here. Though I was sick, I watched the tide. The ocean seemed forever wide. Giant heads of men of old, sticking out of sands of gold. Their faces keep me company, an endless gaze towards endless sea.
That on fire. Oh. Oh. I guess we have two more areas. Make a card. Light a torch ahead, you will rise. Flowers, and there's a torch. We gotta find a coconut or something to burn. There's a coconut. Oh, and another torch. Okay. So we're gonna go around lighting those torches. Burning coconut. Okay, one is up here. It did something. There's one right there. Oh, and another piece of the story. Like these first. Oh, it's raising the pillars. There we go. They're nighttime pillars. And daytime pillars. Thought I'd get something out here. Okay, we gotta get you to rise. But didn't want that. Oh, don't go in the water. Torch. Okay, just gonna set you there for a minute. That's what that thing wants. We'll come back and get our coconut. Okay. Let's go get our coconut. I don't see any more torches here, so apparently we need to go across there. Someone we're missing. Oh, look, here we go. That was it. Alright. Oh, but now you've gone down. Let's make it nighttime. There. Okay, now we can get across. Are they all little faces, rabbits? Okay, let's not put out our fire. Continuing on. Uh-oh. That's gonna squash our fire. Stash that there.
Cliffs and on the ground, these ruins scattered all around. The remnants of those long past gone. Perhaps they died, or just moved on.
We missed a part of our story, so let's go back and find it.
This cave gave shelter from a storm, while fires I lit did keep me warm. 10 burning flames to give me light, all alone in the night.
Oh, now see? If we had found that before, we would have known we needed 10 torches. Okay, let's make it night 10.
Gathered objects for support, sticks and stones to aid my fort, coconuts from the nearby trees, and shells to put my heart at ease, together with the sharpest black, to cut and shape all I brought back.
Okay, sticks and stones, coconuts, shells, and the sharpest black. Stone. What else was there? Stinking stone, coconut, and shell. Stick and stone, coconut, shell. Oh, then we let the fires. Alright. Still need a flint. Symbol through there. Alright. Let's go further down to the gate. Thank you.
At nights, I listened now and then, just to hear the voice again, singing above the ocean roar and closer than the night before.
She's hearing voices. I guess being alone will do that. Thank you. still have fish for some indigestion. And that brings up a thing, okay? I want a rock to eat. Well, they're not very picky, are they? Maybe you like coconut. No? You want me to be closer? Apparently. One more fish to feed. Time is not on anyone's side. All right. Okay, we have a daylight maker. It looks like more story.
I spied a cave beyond the splashing waves below, ever crashing. And begged the moon to give me time, the strength to make this one last climb.
So we want to be nighttime? If she's begging the moon. That's a daytime thing. That's a nighttime thing.
Day to night, and night to day, I knew I had to find a way to meet the woman kept inside, her voice acting as my guide.
Now that is interesting. Do you think there was an actual guide? says it's daytime. Switch it to day, is that? I don't know.
fine.
It's not letting me go that way. It's just having a little hiccup. Okay, that's not to the thing. opened at night.
Here, the origin of the call. I found there was no one at all. Just the wind whistling through empty walls.
We often see what we wish to see and hear what we wish to hear. I guess especially if we're all alone on a deserted island. In the moment, it's probably even more. Okay, let's open. Should we have found our door?
Something was different about this place. The salty breeze caressed my face. It felt as though I was already home, as I buried my feet in the sandy foam. For I was bound to love this land. So here I died, in a blanket of sand.
Well, there's our final piece. That is rather sad. Stories to be told. total one, I guess. Holds all the crystals that I have preserved over many years looking after this place. When a human life passes from the world of the living, I capture the life energy in these crystals to preserve it. Unfortunately, there are several lives I failed to capture, and their time is reaching its end. I can feel everything fading. Those must be the lives we're going to get. You must seek the shaman of Nahil Rain, for he will teach you about love and duty in between the raindrops and ruins. I wonder why there's voiceovers for the poems, but not for him. I kind of imagine him having a kind of a godly voice. Okay, so there she is. Death without legacy, something to be feared, though we had already read that. But there's all of her little things floating around her. Okay, we'll move on to this story. We often do not realize what is most important to us. But we are going to move on to this story in the next video. I hope you're enjoying this. I think it's a gorgeous game, and I like the puzzles. But anyway, until next time, I will meet you again in Xing, and we will go discover the, I don't remember what it's called now, Iztali Point or something like that. Anyway, I will see you then. Bye-bye for now.